However, we've seen some recipes that use quick and instant oats, but this is a no-no. These oats have been part-cooked and then re-dried, and they have almost no flavor, and their texture is really sticky, almost like wallpaper paint. Okay, so these are out. Now, honestly, you don't want to use steel-cut oats. This is not for cookies. This is for a bowl of porridge in the morning. A big, thick, strapping bowl of porridge in the morning.
You'd know about that, wouldn't
yes,
you?
Yes, I would. So here we have 3 cups of old-fashioned rolled oats, and that's the same as you'll see on the back of the canister, so no changes yet. All right, now let's look at the dry ingredients. Here we have 1 cup of all-purpose flour. That's a slight change. The recipe on the canister has a little more flour, but by reducing the flour and leaving the oat amount the same, you're gonna get more oat flavor. To this, we're gonna add a little salt. This is 3/4 teaspoon of salt, and a little baking soda. That's the leavener. This is 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda, and that's also a little bit less. It's gonna make those cookies a little less cakey.
Okay. We don't want puffy cookies.
No, you know, that back of the canister box, it made a really cakey cookie on the inside with crisp edges. But as soon as that cookie cooled, it sort of had a uniform texture that was just stale.
Okay.
We want crisp edges, chewy center.
Gotcha.
And another way that we get a nice chewy center with crisp edges is looking at the